anniversary with benefit concerts, featuring its talented young students who use local string and wooden instruments to make music. Proceeds from the benefit concert will go to Miting Pangharap Educational Foundation, which offers programs that provide free education to Smoky Mountain youth. Here's a number from members of the Philippine Montessori Center. Ensemble. We are joined by teacher Lois Espinosa, teacher Cathy Zulueta, and Charmaine Laconico. And we heard the beautiful music from the children, of course, of Philippine Montessori, all for the celebration of its 45th year, 45th anniversary, right? So we'll be joined by teacher Lois, teacher Cathy, and Charmaine, one of the parents of one of the children in the ensemble. Guys, good morning to you, and thank you so much. We have a big group with us, so thank you so much for getting everything together and coming over. And congratulations on 45 years.
Yes. All right, well,
I guess we'll hear from the teachers first. Teacher, let's hear about the benefit concerts that are set to celebrate the anniversary.
this is, we have, the school has an affiliate school, or it's an outreach program of the school. It's called Miting Pangarap. It's way down in Tondo. Mm-hmm. And these are children who cannot regularly go to school because of the setup there.
Right.
So, and the school is providing the building, the teachers, and even the approach is Montessori. So it's really a big, what's this? A good act of the school.
It really is, and what's wonderful about it is, we saw the children. They're, you know, they're this tall. They're so young. They're already learning their love for music, developing that love for music and for the arts, as well as learning how to give back to other aspects of the community. More on the musical side, teachers. How long? How long has the ensemble been together? And how did you even teach the children to
it's amazing,
to,
right?
to play? That was beautiful music, really.
This ensemble.
Yes, yes.
So we've had the children since June, at the start of school year. So we actually choose the, you know, the cream of the crop at Philippine Montessori Center. So we put them together. So we have the Philippine Montessori Center instrumental ensemble. These are children from the preschool, age 4 to 6. And we also have the Temple Hill International School.
That's
this is from
school.
The grade school. That's our grade school. So it starts from age 7 to 10. So we meet every day to rehearse for an hour during the school year.
Only an hour a day? Wow.
Yes.
But they sound great. They're only practicing
that's every day.
That's every day.
I think I'd need like three to four hours. But so the age range is from 4 to 10, basically.
That's right, yeah.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay. And of course the children, I'm sure, are very excited about the concert and showing off their skills. We have Charmaine here, who's one of the parents, proud parents.
Very proud. It's really amazing how you see the children are so disciplined. I mean, I can't imagine how our teachers here are able to teach them. It's really amazing, and we see their love for music and their dedication to it. I have this short story when I used to pick up Tara and my daughter, and whenever I would pick her up, she'd be like, "Mom, I don't want to go home yet. I still have orf practice." So they really have the innate love for it, and they develop it.
Did your daughter have an interest in music before, and then was it further developed? What kind of things did you see change in her when she became part of the ensemble?
Well, yes. The good thing about Philippine Montessori Center is that it's part of the program that all the kids are, you know, are immersed into music, and then they tap into these talents. And my daughter just, you know, it's in the family, I guess, and then she just started developing it, and her love for it just became deeper and deeper. And not just the love, but the discipline that we see in them is really fantastic. And it's amazing. They're so excited for the concert. They have the upcoming concert in Meralco Theater on the 28th of April. So we hope that we'll see everybody there to catch the kids. And they will be in New York to perform at Merkin Hall. Yes, on the 28th of May. Mm-hmm. So the concert in Meralco is actually a farewell concert for them, which will be a back-to-back concert with the Philippine Madrigal Singers in New York.
That's awesome. Teachers, if we could have your guys' answers, how do you teach them? What kind of process is it like to create this beautiful music?
It's a trade secret. No, the secret really.
Do you give them candy if they do a good job?
No, personally, it's really the time, the amount of time you spend with the children, because our school, I think, it's the only school in the country that has music every day. For like, we used to have it an hour. Now it's reduced 30 minutes, but it's fine. I mean, it's every day. So how can you not make so much out of this?
What kind of development do you see with the children when music is part of their daily routine?
Oh, total person. Like I told her, it's intellectually, emotionally, and socially. Yeah, if we say intellectually, because to us, listening is not passive. It's very active. The brain is analyzing. Like, we teach 4 kids, double Bach. It's really a high music, very complicated. But then they're able to hear each theme coming from each instrument, and when you're following that, well, listening to this music, that's really analysis and critical thinking, very high level of thinking.
That's right. So, you're not just exactly doing what's being told, but you're listening and processing the information.
Yes. It's more of critical thinking.
Yes.
And when you, it's more or less related to math, because when you're faced with music, you have to analyze. There are certain patterns and sequences, which is also visible in math.
So,
because there's spatial reasoning there. And then, of course, it develops the confidence of the children. They become more stable.
Very quickly, I also want to just touch upon the fact that there is a benefit concert. There's a very good cause to this. How important is it, or how do the children really understand and kind of grasp the fact that, you know, what they're doing is also helping other children who may not have the same privileges?
Oh, yeah. Actually, it starts during Christmas, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, we invite the children from Meeting
Pangarap
to
come
to the
over.
Uh-huh. And so they share food and clothes and gifts. Toys. So they're very aware of their school.
So they're also bonds. Yes. And as far as the parents' point of view, Charmaine, I'm sure that's also something that...
Oh, yes. They know that their concert is not just for them, but they're also sharing. So it's a good, it's a holistic approach for the kids. And we're really very proud. All the parents are very proud. We're very proud of the children.
Well, I think we're going to hear some more from the children. I'm so excited to hear more from them. They're adorable. Thank you so much for telling us more. Have a great concert. And once again, that's on April 28th.
Meralco
at the Meralco Theater. And have a safe flight to New York.
Thank you.
All right. Well, we'll take a short break, but we'll leave you with another performance from the wonderful kids of the Philippine Montessori Center. Keep it here on Mornings at ANC. Thank you.